Hey everyone, this is the LEGO City Coast Guard Headquarters set for 2017. It's the big set of this sub-theme for this time around. The last time we got Coast Guard stuff was just a handful of years ago, about 4 years ago, and I reviewed that stuff back then. Let's take a look at what this comes with. Now the name of the set may be Coast Guard Headquarters, but you know, strictly speaking, the headquarters is just this. More specifically, the headquarters is that small building over on the right, which is even smaller than it looks. It has a very generous helicopter landing pad over here, or helipad, and a good-sized helicopter. We'll look at that just by itself. The helipad can be removed and placed wherever you want, so you can orient it however you want for whatever shape of base, for whatever playing space that you have available. This is nice. And that brings us to this. So I'm glad this has a decent sized dock in the front. They made it with a minimum number of pieces, which is smart, and it looks good. The color scheme, using the dark tan here, I think is good. A little bit of detail around here, you know, with the little cleats and the railing, and these are just cargo boxes that have nothing in them. You can put something in there if you have something small enough, the little ladders to go down into the water. I think that's actually pretty nice and a good use of the parts. This section of the structure isn't really anything, you know, it's just completely empty. It just supports the balcony. The balcony is important itself, and it's useful. It's a really good place to pose a figure, but they don't give you any way for a figure to get up there. So you need to use the power of imagination to teleport them up there. Feels like this is space where they could have put in stairs or something, you know, rather than having that unused space below. But I do appreciate the balcony though. Maybe some sort of compromise would have been good. Up top, they have some communication related stuff as well as some lights. You can rotate this around and you can bring it up and bring it down. That's pretty standard fare there. They use the relatively new-ish corner door frame pieces here. I like the integration of the color scheme with the stripes of orange and the blue. Open large windows on these sides, and when you spin it around, then you get to look inside. These two rooms are not bad. That's a sticker back there for that widescreen, wide flat screen TV. It's kind of a break room, I guess. That's good. Could have used just a small table to put the coffee mug on and the newspaper. Otherwise, I think that's a fine use of the space. And then the second floor includes a coffee maker, which is a nice, small, simple, but good-looking build. And they have the whole console over there for dispatch with a computer screen. You got radar there and another printed slope piece off to the side. So that's all good. Again, for the size and the number of pieces, I think that's good. I just wish that this headquarters set had a larger headquarters. You know what I mean? Real quick, here's the helicopter that I moved out of the way. I like the use of the yellow colored engine pieces to serve as the basis for the pontoons, the floats for this thing. And I think it's a decent looking helicopter, nothing too special about it. At least it does have room for a person to sit on the side, and it has room for another person to sit on the other side. So kids playing with this will be able to rescue a person and just place the rescued person over here. So at least it's able to carry two passengers, if you will, in total. However, this has no winch. I think that they're expecting you to just land this on the water, you know, for simulated rescues. That's fine. I would have liked a winch. I feel like I have a lot of bias in favor of this thing because it's triggering some nostalgia for me. It really reminds me of the very first LEGO Coast Guard headquarters set that they did. A lot of things about this are very similar in its overall design, even though this is significantly larger and uses newer pieces. But I think were it not for that nostalgia, I would find this relatively plain and low in features. Very small main rotor that could have been larger for sure. Little tail rotor, whoa, is able to spin up. And it just has a basic cockpit with a single control stick. I think all that stuff is just fine. I think this whole helicopter is just fine. Not great. The main thing that you're paying for with this set is this big old Coast Guard cutter. All right, now we're talking. This is substantial. It does use the same sized hull as the last major Coast Guard ship did. but it has a very different design. They have a very prominent dinghy launch on the back, and that actually works. This entire boat will float, actually physically float in water. It's a sealed unitary hull, unlike the helicopter. This launch actually works. You can activate it from either side, and the dinghy itself is able to float. But yeah, for this, you just turn either of these knobs on either side, and it just slides on out. The dinghy itself is pretty simple, especially with no propeller on the back, but that's fine. You know, this has some accessories on it. That's cool. A lot of space is used up for that launch, though. Quite a lot of space, and I think a lot of the parts budget for this thing. And there's nothing underneath. There, you can't use any of this space under this. You can't use any of the space behind it, including in the superstructure here. The rear half of the superstructure cannot be used. But I really like the level of detail on this thing. I really do. I like the chains hanging down. I like the use of the grill pieces, and I especially like this forward section with the studs on the side construction for the entire thing, and the recolor to orange for this 8-stud wide windscreen window piece. All of this lifts up. I'll show you the inside of that in just a minute, but I love the orange. There's so much of it. And one of those was supposed to go the other way. Sorry about that. Has kind of a sunroof there, you know, a sunlight, if you will, but you could use that as a hatch. It's not something that's easy to get into from the top. Before I get to that part, though, I do want to finish showing you the details on the outside. Radar bar is able to spin around. You can adjust the angles of these lights. You can put somebody up here, just stand them there, although there is a tile there that limits the number of places where you can actually attach someone. The mast goes up pretty far. That's good. A little railing on the side, more lights. And in the front, there's also this searchlight, which can be operated by a person. They just hold on and they're able to rotate around. That's good. I wish it was able to angle up and down also, but this is not bad. And also, the part of the main superstructure that can open up is this front section. So I'll remove that as well, and then we'll take a look at the actual interior detail. Cool. So this is the piloting position. This is the bridge, and the captain there has an actual seat. He has a steering wheel, and he has just a couple of printed slope pieces to give him some instrumentation. Like I said, the space behind there is not usable. There's a lot of space in there, but to access it, you need to really start tearing things apart. So effectively, reasonably, it's not something that's going to be used by kids actually playing with this thing most of the time, unless you're willing to do modifications. And then this is the medical bay here, which includes a stretcher. That's nice. That's actually attached there, but you can remove it. And doesn't really attach to the helicopter, unfortunately. It would have been nice to be able to use that with the helicopter. But on the other side, just a little bit of instrumentation for checking vital signs on a patient and such. And they include, I'm not sure what this is supposed to be, a plasma bottle or something, or bag. Steps on the sides that are supposed to be used for accessing this to get down in there. And just a single syringe or needle. The height of this does not allow you to put a figure in there while the roof is on. You can have a figure who's lying down or sitting on the floor if you can find a spot that works, but they can't be standing up while the roof is on. The civilian speedboat is nice. It's a simpler build than it looks like, but I really like the flow of it. It looks very modern. It looks very complete with its shaping. Of course, it has sprung a leak or two in the hull, so that's not good. The guy probably went over some rocks that were really, really bad, but that's why he's gonna need to be rescued. But I love the lines of this thing. I think maybe this could have been done just a little bit better here, just a little bit of a notch, a little bit of a step there. It does use large stickers for the sides, and unfortunately, those stickers are clear backed, and all of this area down here, this area that's dark red, that's showing the dark red through, that's the dark red of the hull itself. And because it's clear, you can see the bubbles through it. You can see the air behind that thing. I mean, I've burnished it pretty significantly as best I could without starting to do damage, physical damage to the surface of the vinyl there. but I think they could have left that out or made it actually dark red so that you wouldn't see that lighter color coming through. This is a unitary hull also. I like the colors of the dark red and the tan for the top and the insert. It's the same overall design that they've used for a couple of fishing boats now. I think it's just a really good one. This will actually float in the water. You can push it and it'll go for a while because it's got a nice sleek design to it. And you can pull up the two outboard motors back here. If you end up, I guess you could use it with one of the older LEGO City trailers that came with a boat also. But I think the designs of these outboards are simple, but they look good. Overall, this is a pretty good thing. It's also able to hold on to a total of four figures. They don't give you four civilians in this set, but that's a nice technique that they used to offset the seats. Very interesting technique. Those pieces, the black pieces, are attached to jumpers, the light gray jumpers, but also the little bars stick up, which are on those modified 1x2 plates that have the bar on either one bar each that sticks out and then turns 90 degrees straight up. Just looks pretty good, and it has a printed console in the front. The final build in this set is a buoy. I think it's one of the nicer buoys that LEGO has included in a set. I guess they had a little bit of extra parts budget left over and put a little extra into this, so that's nice. Seven minifigures in a set of this size feels okay. I could have gone for another one, maybe two, but this isn't bad. You got a little bit of variety here. I think they could have done without the female specific torso. It could have been just a generic different one, so it could have worked with different heads. But it looks good. I like the logo this time around. I like the level of detail, and I appreciate the use of the sand blue color rather than more of a normal, brighter primary color. Now, these are a bit different, and that's cool. I like the level of detail in the harness on the one on the left. The guy in the middle has just a relatively plain wetsuit, but once again, something that's not a normal primary bright color with the dark red there, including for the cap. The derpy looking dude on the right is the owner of the boat that we were trying to save, and he's got his flare gun there. I think that's a good use, a very good use of the stud shooter piece or assembly. It should be large, and I appreciate getting it in a different color. I think that's really just a good use of that, better than most. Derpy looking dude is also the only one in this set who gets an alternate face, because he needs to have a face for when he is under distress and he needs help as his boat is getting ready to sink. So everybody else has just the one face that you saw. Though there are seven figures in the set, they only give us five pieces to represent life jackets or PFDs, whichever you want them to be. I think they could have included just a couple more. Not everyone needs to be wearing one of these all the time in every single possible scenario, but come on, just include a couple extras. It's not that hard. For a little extra drama and danger, they include one shark in the set, and it's the smaller style one, not the big ones that can fully eat an entire minifig, and one good old octopus that's the same mold that they've had for quite a long time, but still looks good. Final analysis. For me personally, the things I like the most in this set are recolors of parts, like the stuff used for this boat and that piece there. But this set was not made for me. This is a play set for kids. I think as a play set for kids, it's pretty good. It seems pretty fun. It has three things that will actually float in the water. The helicopter is good enough. It has a base, including a place to land the helicopter and such. And it has a respectable selection of minifigures. I just feel like the major things in this set could have been done better. There's so much unused space in this boat. That's unfortunate to me. I could have used, I would have appreciated a larger actual headquarters building, but I trust LEGO to do their research. They have shown consistently that they will make more vehicle-based stuff, more moving stuff in their sets, and that is because they are constantly, relentlessly playtesting their sets and prototypes of potential future sets with actual kids. So I have to defer to their actual experience with actual kids and trust that actual kids, on the whole, not all, but on the whole, tend to prefer things that can be moved around more than the larger structure sets. So in terms of the overall layout and proportions of where they put parts, I think that this is nicely done. But even at that, still, could have done more with the ship, I think. So that's it for my look at this set. Now it's your turn to share what you think. Leave a comment with your opinion from your perspective, but keep in mind that your opinion is your own, and be respectful of other people's opinions as well. Disagreements on subjective things like the designs of innocent toys are to be expected and are completely healthy and normal. Time for me to start work on my next video, so I'll be talking to you again very soon.